Hi there. I thought about a nice project, and this would be to introduce myself a little, because now I'm heading to 300 subscribers and other people who are watching my videos, and I thought that maybe you'd like to know some things about me, some personal things, since I never talk about myself, and this wasn't actually the purpose of this channel. But maybe now, to thank you for your kind words and for following my videos and for your attention, I would like to maybe tell a little more about myself. So we are going to look at this patchwork project that I made during my studies in art school, so that you can have a look into my personal life a little more. And maybe it's a nice way, because this project was very close to me and it tells a lot about me and my way of working. So yeah, it's kind of an artistic way to introduce myself to you. I think I should have ironed it, actually, so I'm really sorry. Usually it's just lying in a drawer. I know. It was on the wall for a while and then I took it off. I like to change things all the time. And so everything, every color represents something or someone. And the idea is to have all the fabrics in each and every picture. So the quantities can change, but I really had to use every fabrics in every picture. So the first one is in the tummy of my mummy. And we are two, because I have a twin sister, and we are just there inside her tummy. The red represents her. And I like the small pieces that reminds me of Klimt. I really like the painter, Gustav Klimt. And that's why I included these small pieces like jewelry. The second picture is after I was born with my mom. I'm the yellow, actually, so everywhere where there is yellow, it should be me or something to do with me. And the shapes are changing also, so everywhere where it's a bit sharp, it's kind of hard, hardness of the life. And everywhere where it's a bit rounded, it's the softness and love and things like that. The third picture is us, our family, and all I can remember from my childhood was traveling and having fun and making excursions and all together. I have three bigger sisters too, and my twin sister and mom and dad. And all I can remember was fun and love and spontaneous things. Nothing too serious. And then suddenly, more serious times came. My mom got sick of cancer, and she was sick for years and years. It was a hard fight for her, and finally she died. And it's supposed to be my hand and her hand and the fields that became a blanket on her hospital bed. I don't remember that much because she didn't want us to come and see her in that state, so I just remember visiting her once or twice, but she was really, really sick that time. And then she passed away. This is my representation of the funerals of us and our big shadows with all the flowers. The jewelry pieces that became flowers. And also the red fabrics that represent her from the beginning became just a grave. Actually, my drawing teacher liked this one very much. He said it was the most touching picture, you know. But there were only these five ready, actually, for my school project. And the other ones, I made them afterwards, later. And these are the following five pictures that were never attached to the rest of it. Maybe one day they will be. The first picture is my father getting remarried with his secretary, actually. And she just came and my father kind of disappeared, like you can see it here. And also did my two bigger sisters, actually, because they could. And we were just there sitting on the last souvenirs of my mom, kind of. Because she just came like an octopus and, you know, covered everything. And it was all about her from that day. It is not a very flattering picture of her, and I wouldn't show it to her. Well, actually, I don't mind about that now. I think it was maybe natural that it happened that way. It just wasn't really my choice, or it wasn't something I would choose for my daughter, for example, but never mind. Have to forget about the past. And then I started to draw. It was around that time I started to really, really draw and paint and everything. Kind of wanted to express that feeling I felt, but I couldn't say, I guess. And actually, art, I think, always comes from suffering somehow. Art and creativity in general. And so secretly, I painted my flowers, like, on the whole story. And I was holding on to the kind of last jewelry bracelet of mom, which is red, of course, again. And she was creative, actually. I think creativity came from her, in all of us, all of my sisters and I. Then time passed by and I got bigger and I left. And I had the big road west where the sun sets down. I came to Belgium when I was 18 to kind of start my own story. And that was a bit frightening at the beginning, but it wasn't planned I was going to stay that long. It's been 16 years now, half of my life almost. And first thing of this story was love, of course. And this partner wasn't there for a long time, as one of my teachers pointed it out. He's not really there, nowhere, a part of that. And it's because he wasn't, really. But never mind. Life just happens. So I started a wonderful new life, which was actually a wonderful new life in me just then. And I was kind of alone for that. But I just think he missed a lot, really. And that was the last one I could sew together, because from that moment I still needed three more. These were the projects, but I didn't have enough fabrics. And as I said, the story was that I was going to put all of the fabrics in every picture. I couldn't possibly continue. So that was a bit sad at the beginning, but then I thought maybe it's because it's like destiny or something, another story starts there or something like that.